Hello, my dear girls and boys, a very warm good afternoon to all of you, and thank you very much for staying tuned to HashLearn. And now, today is 1st of September, right? So almost 1 month over, this month is, today is the beginning. So with this new beginning, whatever has happened, kitna padha, nahi padha, kitna padhna hai, kaise padhna hai, you still have time, okay, if you are in 11th. If you have already passed 12th, then your time is further reduced. But what has happened, okay? You cannot go back in the month of June or in July or August. Ki nahi, ab samay thoda ulta kar dete hain and let's change what happened, okay? So you have to be thinking forward, thinking ahead of what to do next, okay? So with this note, I'll start the class. And very good afternoon, Anushi, and thank you very much for joining the class, and I'm really happy to see one name at least there in the comment section. So I feel that I am no more teaching to the camera. So I was just telling that keep thinking positive, and with the beginning of the month, whatever has happened, you can't change it. Think ahead, theek hai, aage kya karna hai aur acche se karna hai, think that, and with this zeal, you should start the day. And with this, I also welcome Deepak and Ghani Khamba Deepak. Sab badhiya. Hello, Jayesh, and I'm very glad to see your name once again. How are you? And good afternoon. So now on your screen is the recap of the previous class, what we discussed in the previous class. So basically, the last class was mostly devoted on the morphology of cockroach. That means, जो ये छोटा सा प्यारा सा जो प्राणी है कॉकरोच, how it looks externally, entirely the division of the body into head, thorax and abdomen, then wings location, then the structure of legs, all these we have discussed, okay? And based, and then towards the end we have discussed one system also that comes under anatomy only, okay? So digestive system we covered in the last class only, and based on the morphology of cockroach, you were given the CPP, the class practice packs, and the question where most of you have gone wrong is the question now on your screen, okay? Sab khairiyat hai, chalo achhi baat hai, khairiyat rehne bhi chahiye. So the question where most of you have gone wrong was question number 3 of CPP, and this says, with reference to the external feature of cockroach, which among the following statement is not correct, okay? So body is covered by chitinous exoskeleton, which is very much correct. Hind wings are protective and are not useful in flight. Not useful in flight. Hind wing hi to flight hota hai, okay? And then fore wings are also called elytra. Yes, they are also called elytra, and this I have discussed in the last class also. And gonapophysis helps in copulation. So that is correct. This point we will be discussing in today's class. So B will be the correct answer, but most of you have opted for option C. ठीक है, तो option C नहीं होगा, नहीं भी पता था, it is hind wing, okay, which helps in flight. Here it is not useful in flight. Very warm good afternoon, Shubham. I am very well and doing good. How about you? Now, on your screen is the goals for today's class. So, what are we going to discuss in the today's class? So, under anatomy again, we have circulatory system, circulatory system of cockroach, okay? Circulatory system, respiratory system, excretory system, nervous system, and reproductive system. Digestive system we have done in the last class itself. So, ye paanch ke paanch system karne hai. So, fasten your seat belt. क्योंकि अब जो अपना कॉकरोच है उड़ान भरने वाला है. उड़ान क्या भरेगा? वी आर गोइंग टू डिसेक्ट इट, सो इट्स गॉन. ओके, सो नाउ ऑन योर स्क्रीन इज द फर्स्ट सिस्टम, दैट इज सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम. सो व्हाट यू नीड टू रिमेंबर इन द ब्लड वास्कुलर सिस्टम और सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम ऑफ कॉकरोच इज दैट इट इज ओपन टाइप. ओके, ओपन टाइप मीन्स द ब्लड डज नॉट फ्लोज इन ब्लड वेसल्स. ठीक है, वेयर एज हमारे बॉडी में क्या है, वी हैव blood vessels, the arteries, the veins, arterioles, okay, come at no point of time blood simply oozes out into the tissues, okay, whereas in case of cockroach, it is 13 chambered heart and the blood will come out into the ciliary. Okay, all the organs are bathed into that. It's just like you have a glass of water and start pouring things into that, or a vegetable curry. Okay, curry mein sara vegetables hai, waise hi in the hemocele you have all the organs. So that is why the blood vascular system of cockroach is open type, and the body contains blood, but this blood is not equivalent to the blood which we have. We have red blood, but they do not have, because we have hemoglobin, but they do not have. So what is the respiratory pigment in case of cockroach? Which bathes the viscera in it, and therefore it is known as hemocele. ठीक है, hemolymph or the blood in the ciliary, so the word has become hemocele. Blood vascular system consists of a tubular heart blood vessel called anterior aorta. So blood vessel के नाम पर उसके पास सिर्फ एक ही चीज है, that is anterior aorta in the anterior segment. Otherwise there are no blood vessels. And a system of ill-defined blood spaces. देखो क्या है, you have space where this aorta will open and the hemolymph will be present in the ciliary cavity. So sinuses are actually spaces. Even in our body we have spaces, sinuses. The hemolymph is composed of colorless plasma and hemocyte. ठीक है, so plasma and hemocyte, hemocytes are equivalent to the WBCs as in case of us. Okay, and one thing notable here is that this is not the hemolymph or circulatory system responsible for carrying oxygen. For that we have complete tracheal system which is entirely dedicated for gaseous exchange. Now the heart consists of elongated muscular tubes which lie along mid dorsal line. Theek hai, so on the dorsal side, that too in the central part, so mid dorsal line of the thorax and abdomen. Kahan par hai location? Mid dorsal plus in the thorax and abdominal segment. We have head, thorax and abdomen in case of cockroaches. The heart is differentiated into 13 funnel shaped chambers. ठीक है, हमारा heart क्या है, बेचारे के पास चार ही chamber है, उसके पास mansion है, 13 funnel shaped chambers, and that is one of the reason why it is not a true heart. Okay, with ostia on either side. Now ostia किस जानवर का नाम है? What is ostia? The blood from sinuses enter into the heart through ostia and it is pumped anteriorly to the sinuses again. So let's see what they are. देखो यहाँ पर क्या है, this you can see, this is the anterior aorta which I was talking about. These are the heart chambers actually. So heart chambers are like this, connected to each other. Now in each chamber, on the posterior side you have two holes, okay, from where actually the so called blood will enter into the chambers. So that is the ostia. Anteriorly jab ye hum isko aisa chamber bana rahe hain, so this opening is your what? Here this will pump blood into the next chamber. So you can see the direction of the heart, direction of the blood. The blood will go from here, okay, from here to this place, and it will enter in the next chamber, because here you will have valve or the ventricular valve, you can say. Okay, so here you have valves that will again, even the ostia is guarded by valves, like in case of human being. Okay, human being may be kya hai, the auricles and ventricles are guarded by valves. Similarly the ostia and the opening of each chamber will be guarded by valves. So ostia is actually guarded by auricular valves, and this valve is your ventricular valve. Clear? Oh, that's okay Priya, we have just started the class and we are into circulatory system, and I think since when you joined we are in that only. So I was just talking about the circulatory system of cockroach, wherein you have 13 chambers. Posteriorly it has two ostias through which the blood will enter into the heart, and anteriorly through ventricular valves it will go to the next chamber. Okay. Next, the respiratory system. So the respiratory system consists of a network of trachea that opens through 10 pairs of small holes called spiracles. See, this we have discussed in the last class also. It has 10 pairs of spiracles. Spiracles, kya hai? These are nothing but holes through which the air can enter into the body, and inside that, this is outside and this is the spiracle actually, and this one is your trachea, and further the trachea is dividing into finer tracheoles. So these are all tracheoles. Okay, so air will enter, and through this it will go to all the entire tracheal system. It is connecting the entire body, and this ostia, there are 10 pairs of ostia in case of the cockroach, and it is present on the lateral side, sides of the cockroach body, and not on the ventral and dorsal side. Okay, the branching tubes or the tracheal tubes are subdivided into tracheoles, that is what I said just now, and they carry oxygen from the air to all parts. Fine. And the opening of spiracle is regulated by sphincters. So at every opening as the organism is becoming more and more complex, okay, so none of the openings will be like directly open. You will have control in that, and that's why you have the sphincters to guard the opening. Okay, and exchange of gases takes place through tracheoles. Why? Because you can see this here, trachea is thick, and then it is divided into very fine tracheoles. So the membrane of tracheole will be very thin, which will support the process of diffusion. Okay, and now on your screen is the complete tracheal system of a cockroach. So here you can see these are the spiracles. Okay, so in case of thorax we have two spiracles, so that is the first thoracic spiracle and the second thoracic spiracle, and the rest 8 are there in the abdomen. You can see 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 and 8. So 8 in abdominal section and 2 in thoracic, a total of 10 pairs, one on each side, okay, is found in case of cockroaches. And then all these, like say for example this tracheal connection, these are transverse. Once it is going longitudinally, so that is called longitudinal trunk or lateral trunk, and this is how the entire tracheal system is interconnected, and that's how the oxygen will reach to each and every part of the body. Now we are into excretory system, and for excretion they have a specialized structure called Malpighian tubule, which is there on your screen. Now what is the location of Malpighian tubules? कहाँ पाया जाता है Malpighian tubule? कहाँ पर है? Present in the body of cockroach. This we have discussed under digestive system in the last class. So excretion is performed by Malpighian tubules. Each tubule is lined by glandular and ciliated cells. They absorb nitrogenous waste products and convert them into uric acid. So nitrogenous waste in case of cockroaches is uric acid, and that is why they are uricotelic organism. Fine. So human beings are what kind of organism? Ureotelic, uricotelic or ammonotelic? May I have the answer? Hey, I have asked some 3-4 questions today, but I haven't got answer of any. So have you really answered, or you have not answered, so I can't see. Okay, I can see Deepak has answered for yes, junction of mid and hind gut. So that is very correct. Malpighian tubule location is at the junction of mid and hind gut. So after the crop you had hepatic CK, theek hai. So when we draw the digestive system of the cockroach, actually at two places we draw fine hair like structure, fir dusri jagah pe you will have like this. ऐसा गुलदस्ते जैसा कुछ बना देते हैं. दिस इज द जंक्शन ऑफ मिड गट एंड हाइंड गट वेयर वी फाइंड दिस मैल्पिजियन टिब्यूल. सो मैल्पिजियन टिब्यूल इज नथिंग बट दे आर टिब्यूलर स्ट्रक्चर. सो यू कैन सी दिस, दीज आर एक्चुअली द मैल्पिजियन टिब्यूल्स एंड दिस इज योर मिड गट सेक्शन, दिस इज हाइंड गट सेक्शन विच विल लीड टू द इंटेस्टाइन एंड रेक्टम. So whatever is the salt, water, nitrogenous waste that is being poured into the, it is absorbed by the malpighian tubule and through malpighian tubule it will enter into the intestine. And that is why in the last class we have discussed rectum plays a role of absorption, reabsorption of water and salt because they need water conservation. And after that it will be removed, the feces and urine will be removed together. So these are your actually this malpighian tubules. Yes, we are ureotelic. Very good, Shubham and Deepak and Priya also answered between midgut and hindgut. So I'm like happy. I thought maybe the comments are not getting updated. And then in addition to the malpighian tubule, but now it is okay. There is no problem with the comments. So thank you very much. There's no problem. So in addition to the malpighian tubule, they have something called fat bodies or nephrocyte or uricose gland. So what happens, the waste will be simply deposited in these fat bodies. Okay, so this is the, this type of removal of waste or excretion that is called excretion by storage excretion. Whereas in this case, in case of malpighian tubule, it is removed out of the body. But these will be present inside the body only. Now the next system, that is nervous system and very vital system. It consists of brain. So brain ke naam pe kya hai? It has an ganglion. So ganglion is nothing but clusters of nerve. Theek hai? Even in our body we have ganglion. So it's not exactly the brain. It is just the mass way of more neural tissue from where the nerves will arise. So the brain which we can consider is supra esophageal ganglia. Supra esophageal means esophageal ke upar, so that means in the head region mostly. So that is supra esophageal ganglion. And brain gives off a pair of short stout cords, the circum esophageal connectives, that encircle the esophagus and passes downwards and backwards over sub esophageal ganglion. ओके, तो देखो कहानी ऐसी होगी, यहाँ पे यू हैव एन गैंग्लियन, अनदर गैंग्लियन इज हियर एंड इन बिटवीन यू हैव द ईसोफेजियस रनिंग. ओके, सो फ्रॉम सुप्रा ईसोफेजियल वो आएगा पीछे से एंड इट विल जॉइन विद दिस. सो इट फॉर्म्स अ रिंग काइंड ऑफ अ स्ट्रक्चर अराउंड द ईसोफेगस एंड दैट इज वाई दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज नर्व रिंग. ठीक है, सो नर्व रिंग किस किस से बना है? सुप्रा इसोफेजियल अलॉन्ग विथ सर्कम इसोफेजियल कमिशर्स, सॉरी नॉट कमिशर्स, कनेक्टिव्स, सर्कम इसोफेजियल कनेक्टिव्स प्लस सब इसोफेजियल गैंग्लियन. यस, करेक्ट दीपक. फ्रॉम द सब इसोफेजियल गैंग्लियन पासेस बैकवर्ड इनटू द थोरैक्स अ डबल वेंट्रल नर्व कॉर्ड विच बेयर्स थ्री गैंग्लियन इन द थोरैक्स एंड सिक्स इन द एब्डोमेन. सो जो सब इसोफेजियल है, देखो जो नेक्स्ट था इसोफेगस के नीचे, फ्रॉम देयर क्या याद रखना है, अ डबल वेंट्रल नर्व कॉर्ड. सो एक डबल वेंट्रल नर्व कॉर्ड कम्स, डबल मीन्स इट्स डबल एंड इट विल मूव पैरेलल एंड एट प्लेसेस दे विल जॉइन टू फॉर्म और इट विल बेयर गैंग्लियंस. So these ganglions, what there are three in thorax and six in abdomen, so there are total of nine in the thorax and abdomen section. So that will form the ganglion in the thorax and abdomen section. So this all together forms your CNS, that is central nervous system of the cockroach. Stout means little tough, it's not very easily breakable. But whereas if you will touch, it will break. It's very fine. When you dissect the cockroach also, and to obtain that nerve ring intact is a fine task. Okay, only people with some expertise and those who do it very finely and very nicely will obtain that nerve cord. Otherwise, in most of the cases, वो nerve cord जो है वो टूट जाता है. ठीक है, मेरे साथ तो पहले चार पांच बार में nerve cord टूट गया था, पहली बात तो मिला ही नहीं था कि गैंग्लियन क्या है, बाद में पता चला अच्छा यही है क्या, इट वॉज लाइक दैट, ओके दिस इज द गैंग्लियन, आई डिडंट न्यू. सो व्हेन यू डू डिसेक्शन यू कैन एक्चुअली लोकेट एग्जैक्टली वॉट यू सी इन द डायग्राम्स. सो पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ नर्व्स विच आर गिवन ऑफ फ्रॉम द गैंग्लियन सो एज टू इनर्वेट ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी. तो ये तो सेंट्रल नर्वस सिस्टम चला, यू कैन कोलिरेट, वी हैव ब्रेन एंड स्पाइनल कॉर्ड. अब यहां से जितने भी नर्व्स जाएंगी दे विल फॉर्म द पेरिफेरल नर्वस सिस्टम. दीपक बहुत खुश हो रहा है. सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम भी कुछ होता है इनमें. सो इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ अ फ्रंटल गैंग्लियन विच इज सिचुएटेड ऑन द डॉर्सल साइड ऑफ द ईसोफेगस. डॉर्सल मीन्स ऑन द back side, okay, in the head. From this ganglion a median unpaired recurrent nerve reaches to the visceral ganglion. Visceral means down, okay, it the visceral abdomen, visceral ganglion situated on the crop. Crop kahan tha? Digestive system mein. The purpose was storage, theek hai. So situated on the crop and various nerve branches are given off from the visceral ganglion. ठीक है, उस विस्ट्रल गैंग्लियन से नर्व ब्रांचेस आएंगे. नाउ थ्री नर्व्स, टू लैटरल एंड वन मीडियन ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द ऑक्सीपिटल गैंग्लियन एंड द लैटरल नर्व्स आर कनेक्टेड विद द कॉर्पोरा कार्डियका. सो आगे का कहानी याद रखो नहीं रखो, ये जो टर्म है कॉर्पोरा कार्डियका एंड कॉर्पोरा एलाटा, इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दिस टू विल फॉर्म द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम ऑफ द कॉकरोच. ठीक है, विच आर एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड्स. द कॉकरोच, इन द कॉकरोच सेंस ऑर्गन्स आर एंटेने, वी हैव डिस्कस, इट इज सेंसरी इन नेचर. एक टैक्टाइल सेंसेस होगा एंटेना के पास. देन यू हैव द आईज. आईज, द बेसिक कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ आई इज ओमैटीडिया एंड ईच ओमैटीडिया इज हेक्सागोनल इन शेप. ठीक है, एंड ड्यू टू दैट बिकॉज वन आई ऑफ अ कॉकरोच इट्स कंपाउंड आई, सो इट हैज मेनी ओमैटीडिया. तो उसकी वजह से जो इमेज आता है दैट इज कॉल्ड मोजाइक विजन. ठीक है, बट व्हेन मल्टीपल विजन्स आर कमिंग इट हैज इट्स ओन एडवांटेज एंड डिसएडवांटेज. विजन मोजाइक होने के कारण देयर विल बी सम ओवरलैप, सो रिजोल्यूशन विल बी वेरी पुअर. ठीक है, बट द स्पीड विल बी वेरी फास्ट. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट द कॉकरोचेस कैन एक्चुअली आइडेंटिफाई इवन वेरी फास्ट मूवमेंट्स or even very slow movements they can easily say because there are multiple images being formed. Yes, the main hormonal, and this is, there is one term that is called neurohemal system. Okay, that is a term for endocrine gland, or agar usme sare option ho so it will be corpora cardiaca or corporis cardiacum, corpora cardiacum. Theek hai, that should be the correct option along if all of these are given. Okay, so that is the sense organ of the cockroaches, and like maxillary pulp, labial park, anal sursi, so these functions I have already discussed in the last class also. Okay, if for taste you have, then for tactile you have, for chemoreceptors also you have the different structures. Okay, other than these two, okay, the corpora cardiaca and corpora elata, we have, or not we, the cockroaches also have intracerebral cells. Where should I write? Okay, intracerebral cells. And prothoracic glands. ठीक है, सो दिस 1, 2, 3, 4 विल ऑल टुगेदर फॉर्म द एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम ऑफ द कॉकरोच. अनुषी, व्हाट आर यू ट्राइंग टू आस्क? ऑल एंडोक्राइन ग्लैंड, होप सो. आई डिडंट गेट योर क्वेश्चन, कुड यू प्लीज राइट इट अगेन. नेक्स्ट, द नर्वस सिस्टम. सो हियर यू कैन सी यू हैव दिस वन. As I said, supraesophageal position will be the above the esophagus and at the top. Okay, so this is supraesophageal ganglion, and that's why this is brain also. Then you have the subesophageal ganglion, and here you have the circumesophageal commissures. Then these are the thoracic ganglions, and so three thoracic, and then you have six abdominal ganglions. Okay, that is what was discussed in the last slide also. Kaha kya hai? So this is entirely your central nervous system. Now from here you can see the nerves are arising. Okay, and this will innervate all the organs of the body. That will form your peripheral nervous system. Okay, Shubham, I'll do that. One second. Now, on your screen is the contest question for the previous class. So, in the last class, I have discussed asked a very simple question, and this was cockroach belongs to which class under arthropoda? Crustacea, insecta, myriapoda, arachnida. So the correct answer was insecta, and the winner for this contest is none other than Priya again. So congratulations, Priya, and you will get your atom session credited by the end of this class. Okay. So now on your screen is today's contest question. Please answer that. How many pairs of spiracles are found in cockroach? How many pairs of spiracles are found in cockroach? A10, B5, C20 and D8. Question will go off your screen on my count of 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0, and here we go. So we are into the reproductive system of male, and yes, I can see there are many answers on the screen. Okay, Anushi, I explained, so that's fine, right? So yes, and I can see there is correct answer in the comment also, and now we are into the reproductive system, the last system which we are supposed to discuss. So in this, in case of males, the cockroaches sexes are separate, and that's why they are dioecious. Okay, remember, dioecious means you have two different sexes, that means male and female will be separate. Okay, the monoecious is the condition where both the reproductive organs, whether we talk about testis or ovary, it is present in the same organism. So, they will be hermaphrodite or monoecious. Dioecious is between two different organisms. So, dog is dioecious, that you can remember, or D for divorce. That is why the organ systems are present in two different organisms. Fine. So, the cockroach, the sexes are separate. So, it is dioecious. Testes of cockroaches are located in the abdominal segments 4 to 6, 4, 5 and 6. ठीक है? So, these segmentation, kis segment mein kya hai? This is actually important. Okay? Especially the ones which are given in your book. It's okay, Deepak. I comprehended what Anushi said. So, chill. Now, mushroom glands. See, they will have all kind of vegetables in their body. So, not vegetable, it's a fungus actually. So, mushroom gland consists of two types of tubules. A long slender tubule, utricula major, that is called peripheral tubule. This, just listen to the terms, what I am saying. What is its function and what is its location? I will just explain in few seconds. Short tubules, they are called utricula brevioris, making up the major part of the gland. ठीक है? So, this is there. Now, what is this and what is the function of that? We will see. They also have seminal vesicles, and they are found associated with the mushroom gland. All sperms of seminal vesicle are glued together into a large bundle called spermatophore. Yeah, so spermatophore is what? It is the sperms which are glued together where in the seminal vesicle. ठीक है, so reproductive structure is present between 4 to 6 segment. Then they have a pair of testes. Then you have a mushroom gland also where you have tubular system, and then we have seminal vesicle which is present in that area only, and seminal vesicle glues the sperms to form the spermatophore. Next, spermatophore has 3-layered wall. Ab this jo glued structure bana, that has 3-layered wall. The inner wall is secreted by utriculi majors, okay, the larger tubules of mushroom gland. Then middle layer is secreted by ejaculatory duct. So we'll see in the diagram where you have the ejaculatory duct, and the outer layer is secreted by phallic gland or conglobate gland. This phallic gland which is there, this is also responsible for secreting chemicals which helps the female cockroach to identify the location of the male cockroach with the smell. The characteristic smell or the chemical is secreted by the phallic glands. Now here you can see these are the testicles, testes, and this is leading to the vasa deferens. We have discussed, okay, no, not in this class, in the 12th class we have discussed the male reproductive system also. And even if you recall from your previous like standard 8 mein thoda bahut agar padha hoga to, then there you have testes, then you have the vasa deferens, and this is your mushroom gland actually. Fine, so mushroom glands, so long tubules are periphery located, these are the small tubules, and then you have, this is the phallic gland, a small sac like pouch like structure, okay. And while in this only, the this is actually your mushroom gland, and in this only at some places you will find the seminal vesicle as well, okay. And then this is the ejaculatory duct. The purpose of ejaculatory duct is that if through this the spermatophore or the sperms will be ejaculated or released from the body. And then towards the end we have 3 phallomeres, left phallomere, right phallomere and ventral phallomere, and they act like external genitalia for the male cockroach. So there are 3 asymmetrical chitinous structure, they are made up of chitin, and they are also known as male gametophytes or phallomeres, and they are left, right phallomere, left phallomere and ventral phallomere, and that is the smallest one, and that acts like a this external genitalia for the male cockroaches. She got the answer and hope so she said that so now we are into reproductive system of female. So female organ consists of ovaries, oviduct, vagina, genital chambers, spermatheca, collateral glands and female gonopophysis, gonopophysis or ovipositor processes, because this will secrete the utheca. Now see, ovaries, oviduct, very much similar to what we see in case of human the names in case of human reproductive system. Now ovaries of cockroaches are located in the abdominal segment 2 to 6, and each ovary consists of 8 ovarioles or 8 ovarial tubules. So you have in each ovary you have 8 ovarioles, and in case of cockroach the ovaries are also known as panisotic type of ovary because it has 8 different tubules. 2 oviducts from each side open into common oviduct or vagina. ठीक है, so when we will see the structure, the oviducts which are there, they will come and open at one place. So that is correlated with the vagina of female reproductive system, which opens into the genital chamber. A pair of collateral glands are also will also open in genital chamber. Then next, genital pouch or genitrium is divisible into genital chamber in front and uthecal chamber behind. Now, what are these? We will discuss. Okay. Female genitalia consist of three pairs of female genitalia means external genitalia consist of this. We are talking about external. Female external genitalia consist of three pairs of chitinous processes hanging from the roof of the uthecal chamber into its cavity. That only is known as gonopophysis. Utheca of cockroach contains 16 fertilized eggs. Okay. So, the utheca, the external covering over the fertilized egg is actually known as utheca, okay, which is actually released by the phallomius or the gonopophysis. These are small tubules in the ovary that is called ovarioles, and there are 8 in each ovary. Shubham. A nymph of a cockroach emerges out from the utheca. I remember someone asking me difference between nymph and larvae in the very first or second class under classification. So, nymph is actually the developmental stage in case of cockroach, and difference between nymph and larva is that wherever in organism you have larval stage, larva does not resemble the adult. Larva will be entirely different from adult. Adult kaisa dikhta hai usse matlab nahi hai, larva ka apna hi kahani hoga. Whereas nymph does look like the adult, except it is reproductively immature. Second, it does not have wings. Otherwise, it looks like cockroach. Cockroach ka bachcha hi dikhega wo. Larva in whichever group you say, larva does not look like the adult. So that is the difference between the nymph and the larvae. Okay. So, nymph of a cockroach emerges out from the utheca, and a nymph resembles to adult in general structure but lacks wing and mature reproductive organs. So, these two things separate it from the adult. Now, let us look into the reproductive organ actually. So, this is the ovary, okay, and here we have, this is the oviduct common, and then it will merge into the common oviduct. And common oviduct is only named as vagina. Okay. Then you have spermatheca gland. Spermatheca gland is actually present in the sixth segment, you can say that is present in the sixth segment. And then you have the collateral glands. These are these branches which are there, these are collateral glands. And here you can see that when we talk about the common oviduct, this opens into the genital chamber. Okay. So, this is the genital chamber, and genital chamber and vestibulum, the latter half of it together makes the genital pouch, and this is gonopophysis. These are also can be called as the phallomeres, which we have discussed in case of male reproductive system. So, these are phallomeres. And since they secrete the utheca on the egg, so they are also known as ovipositors. Okay. So, this is the structure. So, once the spermatophore, the sperm comes and it gets fertilized, then this utheca will be secreted, and in each utheca you have a number of developing zygote. Okay, it does not mean that in one utheca you have just one fertilized egg. So, once inside that utheca it is there and it will rupture and it will come out. So, that is called nymph, which resembles the adult, but it does not have wing. And the period between two molting, because this nymph will undergo molting. Molting means the shedding of the outer exoskeleton. Jo outer exoskeleton hai, usko hatane ka kaam jo karta hai, that is called molting. Okay, like in snakes and all, we know molting takes place. So, before it becomes an adult, it goes molting repeated number of times. Like in case of the periplaneta americana, the most studied species of cockroach. In that, the nymph undergoes minimum of 13 moultings. 13 moultings ke baad it will become an adult. So, in the same point is there in periplaneta americana, the nymph grows by moulting about 13 times. And most of your questions which are asked in exam, they are asked from periplaneta americana only, because that is the most extensive studied. Agar kuch dusra unko puchna hai, to they will give you the name. In case of like Blatta orientalis, it molts only 6 times. And here you have the hormones which regulate the metamorphosis of the cockroach. So, first hormone is ecdysone, which is secreted by prothoracic gland. So, where we were talking about endocrine glands, there were 4 we have discussed, and then this is secreted by corpora elata. In case of juvenile, the hormone is secreted by corpora elata. So, that is why those 4 comes under endocrine system. Is that clear, everyone? So, even this I just forgot, even this collateral glands, they will also help, their secretions also help in formation of the external thick covering, that is utheca. Okay, so now we are into the summary. So, before we move to that, you talk about what is mosaic vision. So, mosaic, you know, mosaic means like if you remember or recall the mosaic floor. So, in a floor you have multiple different kinds of colored stones, so that we call as mosaic structure. That is why plasma membrane structure is fluid mosaic. Mosaic view comes from the different kind of proteins present on the phospholipid bilayer. So, here in case of cockroach, what happens is when it visualizes, it has different ommatidia, okay, and each ommatidia will focus it separately. So, multiple images are formed. Jaise kahin jaate ho na, you have, if you visit a museum or some palace or fort, so inside if it is decorated, so if you see upstairs, if multiple mirrors are there, so you will see your multiple images. So, similar kind of a thing is there in case of mosaic vision, and because of the mosaic vision, the resolution for the cockroaches is very less, but the difference in speed or any change in the environment, they can easily detect. Okay, so, that is again advantage, and that is, that also makes cockroach mostly nocturnal. So, is that clear? I think Shubham asked about mosaic vision, Shayad, in the beginning. So, now is that clear what is mosaic vision? And in to summarize what we have discussed today, so under anatomy of cockroach, we have discussed the circulatory system, respiratory system, excretory system, nervous system and reproductive system. Circulatory system, you have 13 chambers that you need to remember. Ek hi blood vessel hai, that is anterior aorta. Hemocele is there, the blood is called the hemolymph, finished. Then you have the respiratory system, it is made up of the tracheal system. Trachea opens into the spiracle. How many spiracles? 10 pair of spiracles. That means if I count total, it will be 20 spiracles. 2 in thoracic, 8 in abdominal segments. Kahani khatam. Next, we are into the excretory system. Excretory system, mein you have Malpighian tubule. It is present at the junction of midgut and hindgut. Okay. And Malpighian tubules, mein kya, they will add their secretions, or and also in excretory system, cockroaches uricotelic. Kahani over. Then your nervous system, you have the supraesophageal ganglion, subesophageal ganglion, then circumesophageal connective forming the nerve ring, and from there you have the parallel nerves coming down, which will form thoracic and abdominal ganglia, 3 in thorax, 6 in abdominal, and from there the nerves will come out to give rise to the peripheral nervous system. And that's again end of story. In name of sensory organs, you have antenna, maxillary bulbs, then eye. So, eye, mosaic vision, the unit of eye is ommatidia. This you need to remember. And then reproductive system. So, components of both male and female reproductive system, kis segment mein kya hai, aur kis component ka क्या फंक्शन है, दैट्स इट. एंड देन निम्फ एंड व्हाट इज मोल्टिंग, हाउ मेनी टाइम्स डज इट मोल्ट, फिनिश्ड. सो नाउ थैंक यू फॉर जॉइनिंग विथ मी एंड आई होप वट एवर आई डिस्कस यू हैव अंडरस्टूड वेरी वेल. इफ यस प्लीज डू रेट एंड शेयर द क्लास विथ योर फ्रेंड्स. And now it's CPP time, so you will get the gift of CPP. And please do solve the questions if you have attended the class. If you have not attended the class also, please do solve the questions, because time and again I say question solving is mandatory, because when you solve the question, actually you know how to apply the knowledge which you have just learned. So please, please, please solve the questions. On this note, I take your leave. Bye bye, फिर मिलेंगे इन द कमिंग वीक विथ अ न्यू टॉपिक, ओके, बट विद द सेम फेस. पासपोर्ट यूजर्स प्लीज स्टार्ट सॉल्विंग द क्वेश्चन राइट अवे. गुड लक.